Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. Ashhadu an la ilaha illa Allah. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله. أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله. أشهد أن محمد رسول الله. حي على الصلاة. حي على الصلاة. حي على الفلاح. حي على الفلاح. الله أكبر.
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله تعالى وبركاته. بسم الله والحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه ومن والاه. ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، ونشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا وحبيبنا وشفيعنا وسيدنا ومولانا محمدًا عبد الله ورسوله وصفيه من خلقه وخليله. أما بعد. My beloved and respected brothers and sisters, we just heard our beloved Muaddin, brother Osama Salameh, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless him and his family and bless you all. We just heard his beautiful voice. We used to hear it every Friday. And those who used to come to the masjid on Isha and Fajr prayers, we used to enjoy the voice, the call for the Salah. The Salah, which is the most essential act of our way of worshiping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And unfortunately, we are here in the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. All what we do, just recording short messages to be connected with one another. But nothing really recompense the meeting and seeing one another, especially in the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, where we used to be his guests, honorable guests. You know, when we learn from Hadrat Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to repeat after the muadhin every single word he utters, except when he say hayya ala as-salah and hayya ala al-falah. He taught us to say la hawla wa la quwwata illa billah. What does it mean? It means we'll not be able to come to his houses by our own will and power. We can come to his masjid and visit it by his hawl, by the power and the will and the qadr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's why when we hear the muadhin hayya ala as-salah, hayya ala al-falah, we know in our houses back homes how many people are walking around the masjid, and how many people are making business and deals, how many young people are heedless and playing while the Athan is on, and how many they respond to that Athan and they join as Salah. It's not that many. If you want to go by calculation, it's not going to be even 5-10% of the populations. You know why? Because we cannot walk to the masajid of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by our own will, but the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When we have the intention, and when we have, you know, the way of humbling ourselves to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when we recognize this response, that is la hawla wa la quwwata illa billah, in order to come to the masjid to attend the salah, in order to attain success, hayya ala al-falah, all now are missing. Muslims everywhere, even our beloved house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Qibla, we all faces from every corner of the earth, is closed. The masjid of Hadrat Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, how many of us, whenever one of our members travel all the way there to pay visit or to do Umrah or Hajj, how many of us we say to that person, please give my salam to Hadrat Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Even we can do it from here. Even we can say, send our salah and our salam to Hadrat Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, yet in our hearts and our minds, it's running our souls. We ask the traveler, please give our salam to Hadrat Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We missed all of that. That's why today we not only raising our hands, but we humble ourselves before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala here in His houses, beseeching Him, begging Him, O Allah, O Allah, it's in Your power. O Allah, it is in Your will. O Allah, it is Your decision. Nothing happens without Your permission. So we are here in Your house. Humble ourselves, humiliate ourselves, crying to Allah, to You, asking You, O Allah, relieve us. O Allah, please send this pandemic away from all of us. O Allah, restore our life back. O Allah, help us. We learn the lesson. We learn it. Those they never attend a salah in the masajid, they learn the lesson. Those they used to come, they learn the lesson. We know it is no one but You can help us. No one can relieve us but You. It is You, it's in Your hand. We repent to You. We turn ourselves to You. We humble ourselves to You. We cry to You. And we know You are hearing us. We know You are seeing us. We know You are capable. You have the power over all things. And we know that Hadrat Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam taught us, ادعوا ربكم وأنتم موقنون بالإجابة. Pray, cry to your Lord with certainty, that is, You will answer us. You are the one who taught us. When some of the Sahaba came to Hadrat Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and asked, Ya Rasulullah, is Allah far away from us or He's closer to us? Is He far? Then we have to scream and cry, or He's closer to us and cry to Him. So Allah, You, Allah, send the verse, وَإِذَا سَأَلَكَ عِبَادِي عَنِّي فَإِنِّي قَرِيبٌ أُجِيبُ دَعْوَةَ الدَّاعِ إِذَا دَعَى. Yes, You answer this question direct to us. Say, without saying, say to them, when they asked You about how far I am to them, I am near. You are closer to us. We know that. And You command us to cry to You, to invoke You, and You promise us, that is, You will answer us. So Allah, we Your servants, O Allah, we love You, and we ask for Your love. As Hadrat Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, He taught us these words, Allahumma inna nuhibbuk, nas'aluka hubbaka, wa hubba kulli, وَحُبَّ كُلِّ عَمَلٍ يُقَرِّبُنَا إِلَىٰ حُبِّكَ. O Allah, we ask Your love, and every action draw us closer, which You love, and draw us closer to You. Ya Allah, please, you know, we have only 2 weeks. 2 weeks from now, exactly 2 weeks, and Ramadan will come. So, O Allah, don't deprive us from coming to Your house, to stand together shoulder to shoulder, you know, to cry, to listen to Your Quran, to pray, stand before You and make dua. Accept from us after You have heard us. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi ta'ala wa barakatuh.